prior for me coming to Kenya, I heard about Kibera. And a lot of people, when I saw online, they say, oh, this is the biggest slum in Africa. You don't want to go over there. You had, you know, as they say, Mzungus, as I saw in videos, taking pictures of the people, you know, not even respecting them. They said they had nasty water, crime, disease. You don't want to be there. We'll say, you know what, wait a minute. That's our people. We need to go see them inside the community. So that's what we're going to do today. We'll take a tour of Kibera. Come on with us.
Women power.
Power!
Women power.
Power!
Women power.
Power!
As women, we are doing women for women. So we are just happy with our sister Mora, who has brought you all in. And this is Kibera Women for Peace and Fairness Group, led by our mom, Jane Anyango. And in Kibera, is a place that has been known for the negativity, but we are in for positivities. As women of Kibera Peace and Fairness, as you've gotten us today here, we've been gathering this day, yes, from yesterday, today, because of our politics that are ongoing, we are preaching peace before and after election.
Say your names and then Jen will come and introduce what you do here, because I think it's a very nice organization that helps the girl child. Because there's a study that was done, actually it is correct, but they exaggerated the number that 90% of the women, or rather the girls living in the slums, they sell sex for sanitary towels. So this is the first organization that I've seen that they do handmade sanitary towels and also source from outside to help these girls that they say that they sell themselves for sanitary towels. It was a sad story that was done by CNN? Yeah,
BBC.
BBC.
Yeah.
So, but they exaggerated the numbers, not 99% of women under 17, but a few. We can say, we don't have statistics, but we can say at least a few. So Jen is the director here, I don't know. So you can come and say hello.
Hi everyone, I'm Jen Anyano, the founding director of Polycom Development Project. Working with adolescent girls, we work in 50 schools. We also work with women. And so we are promoting positive ethnicity among the women. You know, in Kenya we have a lot of divisions. So we're trying to bring people together to appreciate the diversity that we have, as opposed to looking at it negatively. So with the girls, we are promoting self-appreciation and worthiness. Our slogan is Jipende. Jipende is a Kiswahili word for love yourself. So everything we are doing, we are trying to get the girls to learn to love and appreciate themselves so that they don't allow people to take advantage of them. Yeah. So what happens is that, you know, there's very high poverty in Kibera. And many people, you know, most parents have their priorities. So mostly buying pads is not one of them. And, you know, these are simple biological processes that must just take place. So girls find their own ways of survival. And among them is just trying to sell sex so that they're able to get their sanitary service.
So in your organization, you know, how many, packages like this that you give out a month?
In a month, we give up to 750 pads, yeah.
Okay, so your operation, like, I know it's costing money. Mm-hmm. So how much are you normally having to, you know, put in or receive donations for to make sure this, you know, can be produced every month?
So the machine itself and the materials were donations from a well-wisher from Australia, but we need money to facilitate the women who are working in the department. So every month we are working with 5 women, and every month we pay them 350 shillings every month, and with that we are able to spend as much as, is it around 20 to 30,000 shillings every month for the production.
So if people like see this and they say, you know, I would love to give to them, or, you know, donate online, are you connected online?
Yes, we are connected online. We have a website. We have polycomgirls.or.ke. So if anyone is able to go on that site, then they are able to get a donate button and can be able to donate for us. We also on Facebook, we have Polycom Development Project. So if you go to Polycom Development Project and like our page, you can still donate money for us. Yeah.
Okay, so the person in Australia, you say Australia is sending, you know, funds here to help out in Kibera, correct?
Yes, we have an Australian lady who has been funding the project here in Kibera.
Okay, thank you. I'm glad to know this because this information is, it should be a lot more people coming to help.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much. We welcome everyone. But we also have our wonderful guys around. They work very hard to make sure that the project is sustained. In fact, they volunteer the mentors when they have their free time. They are able to work here. They talk to well-wishers as well. So it doesn't have to be the big money that people are looking for. The least, $10, $5 can make a difference.
Okay, so now we're going to see the process of how it's done. And, you know, this is, you know, guys, you have to remember, I mean, this is something that these people work very hard to do this just for the, you know, young ladies, you know, in the community.
Okay, thank you so much. So this is our mini factory. We have the wood pulp. And so this is it. So it's cut into pieces. And then we grind it, and it becomes very fine for the cotton. So that is our main material. And then we have the tissue, which is a thick tissue. And then we have the, this is what? Polyethylene film. And then we also have the polyethylene film, which is the leak-proof material. And then we have the tissue, and we also have the nanoven. Oh, it's not here. We have the nanoven as well, which makes someone like feel dry throughout. So, oh, okay, this is a portion of the, we've once grinded the wood pulp, this is what we get. And then, so this is how we cut them and group them into 50s. Sorry, I'm touching them, they're not supposed to be touched. So we group them into 50s. And then, so she's our main girl when it comes to cutting and making sure everything is okay. Please just mention your name.
I'm Christina Como. I'm working with Polycom.
Okay, and then we come in. So this is where we do the grinding. And then we get this. And then after that, now these are, you know, this is almost ready. We have the different materials together. This is the presser. This is what they use to press it, at least to make it firm, before they put on the polyethylene film, which is the top material. And then after that, when they're ready, then they're brought here for sealing. So like this is ready for sealing. Maybe you can show us, because we try to observe hygiene as much as possible. So we don't touch them, just pick one and be able to show us how it is. Yeah, so this is the, so after the leak-proof material, which is in on top, we have the, it's put inside the nanoven, and then it is actually sealed. Is also, can also cut it. So she'll be able to demonstrate that. And so we are supposed to be having women, five women working here. We're supposed to be having at least five women working here. And then after that, they are packaged into, like in tents. So 10 pads are put in one packet. And this is what we give the girls in school. So in every school we give emergency pads. Like as much as we're giving the girls the pads directly, we also give emergency pads, meaning there must be pads in the office in case of emergencies.
Okay. And then back here is just, you know, you put the finished products?
Yeah, so this is where we put the finished products. So once they've produced everything, and then we have been able to count as much as, you know, the amount that they have produced in a day, then we put the thing, we stock them here. Like right now, we're preparing ourselves for a big event on the 1st of November. A big one, over 750 adolescent girls, and we are going to give them the pads. And then these are the small materials from the waste, so they use them to make pillows. So nothing is wasted.
Awesome, awesome. Mm.
So this is what, how they seal them. And almost everything apart from the nanoven is biodegradable. So they are very much environment friendly. And we don't just give the pads alone, we give the pads with panties. So at the beginning of every term, we give a few panties for the girls. Because what you know is that, you know, pads can never be used without panties.
So how is this changing the lives of the girls of Kibera?
The first thing, the most important one is that it improves their confidence. Because if you're sure that you're never soiling your dress, then you're comfortable in class. You're just peaceful everywhere. Mm-hmm. So that is the most important thing. Because if someone is confident, then they overcome so much. Another thing is that, you know, they go to school without fear. And then hygienically, they're guaranteed of their hygiene. What we've noticed again is that so many girls have a lot of infections, and you know, they don't never talk about their infections. You know, sex, talking about sex is a taboo in this country.
Yeah.
People don't have sex, yeah? Mm. So the girls are so scared about talking about the infections in their private parts because they are judged very easily. So with this, we are sure that they are safe, they are very comfortable, it's healthy, and it's also breaking that barrier, you know, the conversation barrier. People can start conversing about the private part, which is not very common. And it also keeps girls in schools.
Yeah.
A confident girl would like to be in school, they're comfortable in school, they're doing everything without fear. In fact, some very interesting success story is that we had some big music festival last time, organized by our late member of parliament, and we decided to go and we organized a display tent. And what we noticed is that this is a need whenever we're having activities for the girls, because those emergencies are there. And girls will act very confidently when they have their pads on, or if they are sure that they are going to access the pads. Because, you know, the teachers or people will judge them for not performing to the latter. But they don't know what is happening in their bodies. The moment they sense that they are, their periods are on and their pads are there, the pads are not there, then they can't perform. They can't dance, they can't participate in sports. At the end of the day, they can't tell people it's because of my periods. They end up being punished for it.
We'll do that. And actually, most fathers, because mostly they are the ones who do shopping, household shopping, they will not include that in their budget. And that is why as daughters or as women, we cannot talk to our fathers about our periods. It's a taboo. So we end up doing suffering. We end up suffering because we can't talk about periods and we cannot help ourselves because we don't have money to buy sanitary towels. So for me, actually, I thank this project because it has really kept the women, the young girls at school. And the issue of maybe exchanging their bodies to get such cheap stuff like sanitary towels is going down. Yeah, so I hope that she can reach more girls because right now she's reaching 750 girls a month. So I hope that she can reach up to 3,000, 4,000 as time goes by. So she's doing a good job. And actually, that also tells you that she's promoting talents for these young girls. Because when you're confident and we have maybe music, you're very good at singing, and oops, your period is on and you're like, it's gonna go down. So you're like, you panic and you can't perform. But when you know that you have sanitary towels and you can access it easily, any girl can just come, pop in and pick a pad and go. No one asks for money. So I think she's doing a great job.
Yes. And in fact, the girls are encouraged to, like the teachers, the schools, they know that if a girl goes and asks for permission to come to Polycom, you don't delay. Like, I'd like to go to Polycom, it's like, just go. So it's promoting a lot of, you know, a lot of opportunities for girls to be able to share about their problems. So at times it's not just about the past. We had a very interesting story the other day. So we had this young girl who thought she was pregnant, and she was very worried. Okay, she was psychologically pregnant for 3 months. So the girls organized and told the teacher that we have to go to Polycom. And as usual, the teacher allowed them to come to Polycom. Those are the girls who had seen this girl in distress. And they came and explained to the mentors that, you know what, we have a girl with a problem. So can you do, we have something we call the Jipendi Assembly. So they organized for a Jipendi Assembly. It's a space where you just have girls together and you talk about a specific issue. You give them stories and they are able to, they are encouraged to write whatever the responses they have. In a we have a platform, we call it the talking boxes. So we install these boxes in schools and the girls are able to write anything and share. So when we got a content like, you know, how do you know that you're pregnant? Then we knew, okay, so it's pregnancy. And we were able to get to the girls. She was cancelled and she was taken to the hospital for test, and thank God, she was negative. So it's very interesting how all these you know, organized girls to be able to speak about issues that they would not speak about with anyone.
Free pads, because that is nature. And condoms is an urge.
Choice.
It's a choice. You can choose to have sex or not. But periods is just natural. Yes. It will happen every day of the month. So it's either they sell the condoms and give us free sanitary pads. We championed that campaign and we petitioned the government. They're yet to act, you know.
Yeah, in fact, so you should go to World Health Organization,
yes.
WHO. Why should we have free condoms and not free sanitary toys? You know, why? And then everyone is talking about promoting girls' education. How do you promote education without talking about menstruation? How do you like talk about early motherhood or early pregnancy without talking about menstruation? So it's double standards. We must start from the beginning. We must talk about menstruation. We must give girls the opportunity, you know, the solutions to be able to survive. You know, if we have Panadols and all these painkillers everywhere, why don't we have pads?
God bless you. You're doing the Lord's work. This is the real work. You know, and I tell people, instead of sending them tithes to those churches, send your tithes to a place like this, mm-hmm. and actually be going out to the community.
Yeah. I wish we just have enough pads for the girls, and I wish it would change the lives of these young women who are giving their whole to be able to produce the pads.
Thank you so much for what you do.
So what I experienced is something that just so overwhelming for me, just as a father, and some of the stories that I heard that when young girls go through. I'm a father of three daughters, and to hear what girls are going through for basic needs is just, you know, heartbreaking for me. Very, very heartbreaking. And to see that people are doing the best that they can, they you know, working what they have, and they still have a cheerful spirit. That's what really, you know, got me, because a lot of us in America, you know, we don't have one thing and we're falling apart. We don't have the latest this, the latest that. We can't keep up with this group of people, that group, we're falling apart. But I have literally seen today that there's so much help that's needed globally with the global family, and that we gotta come through. Because what I was listening to is, you heard earlier that an Australian woman is helping fund the effort to help the young girls in this community. And a lot of us didn't know, including me. So now that we know, we gotta do something about it. The sisters upstairs, great sisters, great, great sisters. I love the energy. You know, you saw the positivity, and that's what we need to see. And that's what I support, is positivity in the midst of anything. And if we could just hold ourselves together and keep going, that's what it's about.